Good evening. Welcome to Frontier Regional's last ever virtual class night. We want to welcome our parents, family, and friends. Welcome to our teachers and staff, and welcome to the class of 2021. And I want to say congratulations to our forthcoming graduates. Graduation marks a transition in our lives. For you, your family, and your friends, greet that change with an openness and an eye towards the future. If the past year and a half have taught us anything, it's to take a new perspective on life, to roll with the punches, and to always keep the big picture in mind. Parents, a big thank you to you as well for all you do and for your children and for our school and for our community. We are all grateful for the work that you do. We want to thank you. This has been a challenging year and we're grateful for your dedication and patience.
And now, the national anthem by our very own Aidan Gray. Next up for everyone, we have the Dedication and Appreciation of the Yearbook by Kaylee Wisman and Hannah Ravish.
As we all know, this year has been a crazy year, and as a class, we have so many people to thank. We want all faculty and staff to know that their efforts did not go unnoticed throughout the year. From the bottom of our hearts, thank you for making this year the best year possible. We also want to thank Sophia Rossi for writing our class dedication and appreciation.
Yearbook Dedication 2021. Dedication to Mr. Modesto, Mr. Lanitas, Mr. Dredge, and Ms. Mitchell. The 2020-2021 school year has been one like no other of this. There is no question. As students, we often felt confused, scared, and even hopeless. And as seniors, we felt robbed. With so much negativity circulating, it was so difficult to find the right path through this year. Through all of this, however, some beacons of light stood out. Mr. Modesto worked tirelessly, spent hundreds of hours, including meetings, wrestled with the school committee and union, and endured a constant phone call and planning with Mr. Lanitas and Mr. Dredge, exercised incredible creativity and perseverance in the face of the adversity. They found the ways to ensure that all students had necessary materials and felt safe while accessing those materials. Ms. Mitchell wrote and rewrote schedules accommodating for the leaving classes, mass breaks, and ordering tents for faculty and staff. These people were the pillars of light and hope, guiding Frontier through the dark forest that was this past school year. It seemed that every time the path became apparent, the forest moved and the route was once again clouded with fog. Even so, Mr. Modesto, Mr. Lanitas, Mr. Dredge, and Ms. Mitchell forged forward and never gave up on the students. It is for this outstanding determination, unrelenting dependability, inspirational ingenuity, and genuine hope that the class of 2021 chooses to dedicate this yearbook to you. Thank you.
Our appreciation goes out to Ms. Deleuze, Mr. McDonald, the lunch ladies, and our custodians, Mr. Hildreth, Mr. Rochette, Ms. Brissette, Don Tessier, and the second shift. Sanitizer. a word we never knew we would hear so often. Quarantine, face masks, social distancing. These words used to be so unfamiliar, strange, and scary. Now, they are completely integrated into our daily lives. In contrast, custodian and lunch lady are phrases we have known since elementary school. They've always been a part of school, a warm reminder of the vast community around which our lives revolve. In March of 2020, the meaning of the words changed greatly. No longer were they just the smiling faces who helped us through the day, but they became players of extraordinary importance to facilitate any semblance of normalcy. No longer could we take for granted the services they provided, because although they were more necessary than ever, they were also more difficult to access than ever. But the Frontier staff was not deterred. Ms. Deleuze and Mr. McDonald, as well as the lunch lady crew, were instrumental in keeping all Frontier students fed throughout not only the school year, but over the summer as well. Meanwhile, the custodians were constantly sanitizing the building and making the school a safer place. Through the efforts of all these people, the students of Frontier have been able to march forward with their education without fear. We, the class of 2021, appreciate all of your efforts, without which we could have not been able to have a senior year at all. We, the class of 2021, appreciate all of your efforts, without which we would have not been able to have a senior year at all. Thank you.
The Superintendent's Award this year is given to Isabel Brown. Our superintendent, Mr. Darius Modesto, will now present this award.
The Superintendent's Award is given to a student who represents academic excellence, school and community involvement, and is of quality of character. The Frontier Regional School District's 2020-2021 Superintendent Academic Excellence Award is given to Isabel Brown, who is a senior from Deerfield.
We're in the library now. During Ms. Brown's years at Frontier Regional, she has maintained maximum honors and has a 4.50 GPA, which actually has risen since I originally gave this award in December. In addition to her academic success, she is serving as President of Student Council and has been a member since 2016. She's been in the class government since 2019 and was the founding member of the President of the Interact Community Service Club in 2019. We're in the drama closet now. Why? Because there's a class in the auditorium. But we're in here because Ms. Brown has been a part of the drama club since 2016, and she's had a lead role in both Annie and Harvey. We're in the band room now. Guess why? Ms. Brown has also been a member of the marching band, the wind ensemble, and has been a sectional leader and a member of the band council for 2 years. She's been a member of the Frontier Jazz Band. She's been participating in the Quabbin Valley Music Festival for the last 3 years. Has been a member of the Pioneer Valley Youth Orchestra since 2018, and also has been a member of the Amherst Community Band since 2016. So play on, Miss Brown. She's never seen this guy.
She's on the tennis team.
She's also swam competitively with the Amherst Tritons for the last 10 years, but not in this pool. She's also won the Medusa Mythology Exam Award, the National Latin Exam Award, and the Bausch & Lomb Book Award. Good looking. Had I known you were going to follow me back to my office, I would have cleaned up. To finish up, Ms. Brown is planning on majoring in mathematics and will be attending Clarkson University this fall. So from all of us at Frontier Regional, congratulations on this year's Superintendent Award winner, Isabella Brown.
The next piece of our evening is the awards presentation. First up, we're going to do Junior Awards. The University of Rochester Bausch & Lomb Honorary Science Award for Outstanding Achievement in Science is presented to a student in the junior class at Frontier who has attained the highest scholastic average in science subjects. This year's recipient is Sri Chakrikra Gudmila.
The Smith Book Award is given to a junior whose academic work reflects strong intellectual curiosity and independent thought, whose extracurricular involvement shows leadership and a concern for others, and whose personal qualities exemplify self-discipline and a sense of purpose. The Franklin County Chapter Award is given to Emma Clancy.
The Student Sage Award is given to a student at Frontier who is an academic and social leader, top academic achiever, involved in school and community improvement, and motivated to serve and inspire others. This year's recipient is Leonardo Franceschi.
The Dartmouth Book Award is presented to a student in the junior class with outstanding accomplishments in scholarship, leadership, and service. Congratulations to Joseph Thompson.
The University of Rochester Frederick Douglass and Susan B. Anthony Award for Outstanding Achievement in Humanities and Social Science goes to Maeve Hewitt.
The St. Michael's College Book Award for Scholarship and Service recognizes outstanding students who demonstrate a commitment to volunteerism and community service. We are honoring two students this year, Emily DeMaio and Jacob Haneski.
The University of Rochester Xerox Award for Innovation in Information Technology is given to Daniel Giswaldi.
The University of Rochester George Eastman Young Leaders Award is given to a student who shows strong leadership, excellent grades, and significant involvement in her school community. This year's award goes to Sadie Ross.
The Elmira College Key Award is presented to a student who has shown excellent academic achievement and noteworthy school leadership. We are honoring two students this year, Kevin Bauman and Lily Markey.
The Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute Medal is given to a junior who exhibits excellence in mathematics and science and significantly contributes to the school and community. Please honor Samantha Scanlon.
The Western New England Book Award is presented to a student who shows a high level of leadership through extracurricular activities and community service. Please recognize Patrick Boyden.
The Assumption College Book Award is given to a student who exemplifies academic success, leadership qualities, and concern for others. This year's recipient is Caitlin Mackin.
The Suffolk University Book Award is given to a student who exemplifies a commitment to their education and school community. Please recognize Ian Spearance.
The Brandeis Book Award for Social Action and Civic Engagement is given to a student who has demonstrated a commitment to civic engagement, community service, political activism, social justice, or volunteer work. Congratulations to Isabel Marapizzi.
The LaSalle University Book Award honors a junior who is tenacious, willing to face a challenge, and who consistently pursues the greatest version of themselves. This year's award goes to Sierra Young.
The National Latin Exam was taken by about 130,000 students this year. This exam tests basic knowledge of vocabulary, grammar, history, mythology, and culture, and is correlated with the student's current level of Latin. Award levels include cum laude, magna cum laude, maxima cum laude, a silver medal, and summa cum laude, a gold medal. Three Frontier students earned awards on this year's exam and are to be commended for their achievements on this challenging and competitive exam. Our first recipient is a freshman who has earned a magna cum laude in Latin 1. Please congratulate Patrice Moriarty. Our next recipient is a sophomore who earned a magna cum laude for intermediate Latin. Please honor Bianca Puera. Our third recipient is a sophomore who earned a maxima cum laude silver medal for intermediate Latin. Please recognize Victoria Weigel.
Next up in our program is the Senior Awards. The Outstanding Excellence in the Visual Arts Award has three recipients this year. Our recipients demonstrate an excellence in the visual arts, not only in the classroom, but beyond. These three students show dedication to develop their skills by devoting their time and focus to problem solving, craftsmanship, experimentation, and of course, creativity. These students competed in competitions, worked collaboratively, and explored a variety of media throughout their high school experience, and have grown as artists and as individuals. Please honor Kevin Liu, Claire Winston, and Heaven Woods.
The Medusa Mythology Exam is an independent study international competition for mythology enthusiasts. This year's theme was Monstrous Mutations. This year we have three award winners. One is a senior, one a junior, and one a sophomore. Please congratulate our sophomore recipient first. She has achieved the Magna Award. Please recognize Victoria Weigel. Our junior recipient has won the Maxima Award. Please recognize Samantha Scanlon. Our senior recipient has won the Magna Award. Please recognize Isabel Brown.
The Audiovisual Technology Service Award is given in recognition of audiovisual services here at Frontier. The recipient this year is recognized for his unselfish giving and dedication to the Frontier community with audiovisual technology assistance. He has given countless hours during and after school in support of needs in the auditorium and beyond. Some of the events he has helped with include award ceremonies, musicals and plays, elementary through high school concerts, in-school lectures and activities, dance recitals, town meetings, class nights, community workshops, college workshops, music telethons, sports banquets, assemblies, and coffee houses. Frontier is truly grateful to have had someone grace our halls with such good spirit and dedication. Please congratulate Josh Levine.
The Excellence in Computer Science and Digital Literacy Award is given for achievement in computer science and digital literacy. The recipients demonstrated that when faced with challenges, these students seek ways of overcoming them to achieve mastery. They reach above the norm to solve complex problems and are true explorers in the field of digital media creation and computer science. Please honor Dylan Keynes, Kieran Dowd, Mary Lawrence, James LeClaire, Peter Newman, and Megan Self.
Our next award is the Frontier Community Access Television Volunteer Award. The recipients participate extensively in community media productions outside of the school day. Like commissioned historians, they capture important moments in our lives here at school by filming and photographing both Frontier and other community events. They play an important role in capturing our school pride in sports, music concerts, and also support the general community in town governments. Their work can be found on the school website and the school's Facebook page and cable TV. Frontier appreciates their hard work and dedication, so please recognize Josh Levine and Megan Self.
The Leonard Bernstein Award is in honor of the long career of Leonard Bernstein as a conductor, composer, and teacher, and the indelible mark he made on the musical world. This year, the award is presented to a young lady for her musical contributions, dedication, and her positive influence to her fellow students of the string orchestra. Please honor Lanesha New.
The Director's Award for Orchestra honors the top leaders of an orchestra. Our recipient is being presented this award for outstanding musicianship, dedication, and leadership while being a member of the string orchestra. Please recognize Kieran Dowd.
The National School Orchestra Award is being awarded to a student for her excellence in playing, dedication, leadership, and even her willingness to switch instruments in seventh grade when a cellist was needed. She played the violin and had to learn not only a whole new instrument, but a whole new musical clef. Please congratulate Zoe Gottschalk.
The Band First Chair Award is presented in recognition of outstanding musician performance, leadership, dedication, and cooperation that has contributed to the excellence of the band. Please recognize euphonium player Oliver Sacri.
The Band Musicianship Award is presented in recognition of outstanding musicianship and distinguished musical excellence in the high school band. Please honor guitarist and percussionist Bailey Lenarczyk.
The National Marching Band Award is presented in recognition of outstanding contributions and achievements on the field with the marching band. Please recognize flutist and French horn player Madeline Leon.
The Woody Herman Award is named for the famous American clarinetist and big band leader of the same name. This award is presented to a high school senior for outstanding contributions to the jazz band. Please congratulate Sabrina Dawson.
The Patrick S. Gilmore Award was introduced in 1994 in honor of the legendary 19th century band master and impresario. Among his many achievements, Patrick Gilmore organized concerts with thousands of musicians and performed to audiences of over 30,000 people. He is admired and respected by his peers. Please honor French horn and piano player Isabel Brown.
The Louis Armstrong Jazz Award was introduced in 1974 with the approval of his widow, Lucille Armstrong, to honor outstanding jazz students. This award recognizes the highest achievement in jazz performance. This year's recipient has been a dedicated member of the Frontier Jazz Ensemble, who has released many original compositions on streaming music platforms such as Apple Music. He plans to pursue a career in music. Please honor trumpeter, bassist, and guitarist Aidan Gray.
The Director's Award for Band recognizes enthusiasm, cooperation, and service to the band, as well as dedication to the music department. Please congratulate bassist and trombonist Claire Winston.
The John Philip Sousa Award recognizes superior musicianship, dependability, loyalty, and cooperation. These are certainly the qualities that all band directors strive to develop in their students. It is the only award voted on by the members of the band. Please congratulate saxophonist Haley Belchi. In memoriam, in lieu of his annual scholarship donation in memory of his mother Nancy, Paul Olszewski is donating to the Frontier Band Program in memory of Cole Baranowski. The donation in memory of Cole will have a lasting impact as the funds will be used to purchase an instrument that Frontier students will be able to use for years to come. The instrument will exhibit a commemorative marker in Cole's honor.
The Senior English Award is awarded to four recipients this year. Throughout the past 3 years, these students have grown and flourished, and even with the struggles of remote learning through a global pandemic, found the stamina within to challenge themselves in multitudinous ways. These students have grappled with big questions. They've looked trepidation in the eyes, and almost always, if not always, curiosity came out on top. They've inspired us as teachers to learn more, to be honest with ourselves and with others, and to keep sight of what it means to be human and always, always write our way through it all. Please congratulate Spencer Braverman, Jillian Gochinski, Malia Haynes, and Sophia Rossi.
The English as a Second Language ESL Award is presented for excellence in English language acquisition. The award this year goes to a student who has displayed a consistent commitment to learning English as a second language over her high school career. Her dedication to learning both academic and social English while adapting to a new culture is most significant and commendable. Her warmth and kindness have been apparent to all over her years at Frontier, and the bright spark of her presence will be missed by all of us. Please congratulate Ruth Artiga de Paz.
The French Senior Award recipient is a remarkable senior who has shown an enthusiasm for all things French. From French Honors Class to French Book Club, first semester, and French Cine Club, second semester, she is most worthy of this award. Please recognize Olivia Rosewarne.
The Senior Latin Award this year goes to three remarkable students. All have achieved the highest marks possible in all four levels of Latin and have distinguished themselves by going above and beyond the requirements at every turn and in every aspect of their Latin classes. Congratulations to Isabel Brown, Jillian Kaczynski, and Malia Haynes.
The Excellence in Spanish Award goes to a young man this year. Our recipient has grown tremendously, not only as a student, but as a person as well, during his years at Frontier. He eagerly learns about other customs and cultures and displays compassion and curiosity about the world around him, both in and out of the classroom. He's the type of student who not only participates in class, but also continuously studies on his own in a desire to improve his Spanish. Due to his dedication and work ethic, he has developed amazing second language skills over the last 4 years. He went from knowing just a few greetings as a freshman to speaking and writing near fluent Spanish. He will be continuing his studies at Boston University, but do come back and visit. Buena suerte in all of your future endeavors. Please honor Spencer Braverman.
The Mathematics Achievement Award this year honors 13 seniors. These students have achieved something quite extraordinary. While the graduation requirement of Frontier is to take 4 math classes, these students have taken 7. As part of this commitment to their education, they have spent the last 2 years taking not one, but 2 advanced placement courses, AP Calculus and AP Statistics. We are proud of them and are glad to be able to recognize all of their hard work and dedication. Please congratulate Isabel Brown, Olivia Dean, Skylar Denny, Sophia Dorsho, Kieran Dowd, Aiden Gray, Malia Haynes, Mary Lawrence, Ben Martino, Charles Penza, Abby Roberts, Olivia Rose Warren, and Long Yao Xu.
The Academic Excellence in Science Award has 2 recipients this year. Our first recipient has gone above and beyond in AP Environmental Science in this trying year. Her contributions to class discussions, probing questions, and her passion for the content have helped push the whole class forward. She always comes to class with a positive, as a proton attitude, a smile on her face, and a willingness to help her peers. She gave every assignment, from the smallest daily classwork to her final research paper, 100% effort. Please honor Charlotte Dulette. our second recipient, has shown excellence in science. She has taken on two heavy math AP science courses in physics and chemistry. Within these classes, she has demonstrated consistent effort and has catalyzed a solid understanding of both mathematical and science concepts. Her ability to solve problems, derive conclusions from experimental data, and communicate findings through clear and concise writing have allowed her to achieve a successful bonding of knowledge. This will serve her as she pursues science and engineering in college. Please recognize Sophia Dorshow.
The Civic Engagement Award in Social Studies is presented to a student who goes above and beyond in the study of American government and the social sciences. This award winner is a great critical thinker and strives to understand all sides of very difficult and controversial issues. Please recognize Olivia Rosemorn.
The Global Issues Awareness Award in Social Studies is presented to two students this year. They have both shown a real passion for understanding history and human rights through the study of history and other social studies courses. Please congratulate Jillian Gutchinski and Malia Haynes.
The Historical Curiosity Award in Social Studies is presented to a student who has shown a growing passion for learning about our past and how this helps us understand our world today. Please honor Bailey Lenarczyk.
The Humanities Award in Social Studies is presented to a student for her love of learning about the world and her ambition to work to improve the well-being of all human beings. Please recognize Sophia Stilla.
The United States Significant Citizen Award in Social Studies is presented to a young person who demonstrates continuous enthusiasm and dedication to the demands of U.S. history. They use scholarship as a springboard to explore the demands of strong civic participation. Please congratulate Kieran Dowd.
The Special Education Department Student Achievement Award is presented this year to a young lady. Throughout high school, our recipient has worked hard to maintain excellent grades in all her classes, putting in extra time to do so when needed. Her focus and determination never wavered. She has continually challenged herself to improve academically and did so even during last year's difficult remote learning period. She plans to continue her education after high school as she pursues a career in the field of phlebotomy. Please honor Hannah Richardson.
The Silver F Award is an award which recognizes achievement in school and community. Through their high school career, students earn points toward the Silver F in three different categories: scholarship, service, and extracurricular activities. There are 29 recipients this year. Please hold your applause until all have been recognized. Please honor Thomas Alber, Allison Barnes, Catherine Bizio, Catherine Bizio, Spencer Braverman, Isabel Brown, Sabrina Dawson, Olivia Dean, Skylar Denny, Sophia Dorshow, Charlotte Dulette, Jillian Gutchinski, Aiden Gray, Malia Haynes, Riley Isler, Yannick Johnson, Maya LeClaire, Madeline Leone, Genesis Locke, Madeline Lustenberger, Mackenzie Peon, Sean Richter, Abigail Roberts, Olivia Rosewarne, Sophia Rossi, Ethan Russell, Oliver Sacri, Sophia Stilla, and Kaylee Wisman.
Scholarships and Senior Night Awards may be picked up after our commencement ceremonies at a table near the exit. And now, I'd like to introduce a musical piece chosen from our Winter Strings Concert.
And now for the presentation of our class gift.
Hi, we're the president and vice president of the class of 2021. Remember this?
Hi, I'm a student here at Frontier, and I think I can speak for all of us when we say, we love the water here at Frontier.
Moments like this are funny. We know how important water is.
That's why for our senior gift, we are giving a hydration station to the second floor.
At this time, we will be awarding scholarships.
Allison Barnes will be receiving the Fred Wells Scholarship.
Kyle Barnes, receiving the Myron Rocky Rakozak Award and the Fred Wells Scholarship.
Hallie Belcher will receive the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the George E. Bell Jr. and Louise S. Bell Memorial Award.
Catherine Bazzaio is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Caleb Charles Kinney Memorial Scholarship, the Don Maynard Memorial Scholarship, the David L. Scott Memorial Scholarship, Women of the Moose Chapter No. 316 Medical Field Scholarship, and the Daniela Zinn Memorial Scholarship.
Spencer Braverman will be receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Isabel Brown is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Big Y Scholarship, the Deerfield Lions Club Memorial Award, the South Deerfield Women's Club Scholarship, and the Jenny Brzozowski Zaremba Memorial Award.
Skylar Berniski is receiving the Deerfield Police Relief Association Award.
Amanda Canepa is receiving the Conway Festival of the Hills Scholarship.
Michael Cordiff is receiving the Matthew Herman Scholarship.
Sabrina Dawson is receiving the Daniel Gilmore Memorial Scholarship.
Olivia Dean is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the FRS Character and Athletics Award, the Frontier Regional School Committee Award, and the John F. Skrosky Memorial Award.
Skylar Denny is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Sunderland Men's Club Lillian Dill Scholarship, the Sunderland Women's Club Mildred Goodyear Math, Science, and Technology Award, and the Yankee Candle Scholarship.
Jacob Dodge is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Sophia Dorshow is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Charlotte Dulette is receiving the Deerfield Lions Club Memorial Award, the Deerfield Police Walter Decision Memorial Award, the Myron Rocky Rakozak Memorial Award for Academics and Athletics.
Dan Dragicevich is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship and the Timothy Patrick Merritt Scholarship.
Emma Juba is receiving the Hail Clap Post 3295 VFW Scholarship.
Tanner Finch is receiving the Michael G. Kavanaugh Award.
Brooke Flanders is receiving the Amherst Area Chamber of Commerce Cooley Dickinson Healthcare Scholarship, the Barbara Bannis Memorial Award, the Sergeant Gregory Belanger Memorial Award, the Conway Festival of the Hills Scholarship, the Conway Sportsman's Club Scholarship, the Carol DiOrio Memorial Award, the Laurie Ann Richards Memorial Scholarship, the South Deerfield Women's Club Scholarship, the Fred Wells Scholarship, and the Yankee Candle Scholarship.
Ashley Gaczynski is receiving the Michael R. Skibiski Memorial Award.
Jillian Gaczynski is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Zoe Gottschalk is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Aiden Gray is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Deerfield Lions Club David Carkett Memorial Award, the Kathy Mosier Memorial Scholarship, and the Fred Wells Scholarship.
Malia Haynes is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship and the Alice Spindler Award for Excellence in English.
Riley Isler is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Albert Hearing Scholarship, the Class of 1969 Scholarship in honor of Michael Ferriter, and the Fred Wells Scholarship.
Alec Kirkendall is receiving the John F. Skrosky Memorial Award.
Kennedy Cocott is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Conway Festival of the Hills Scholarship, the Conway Sportsman's Club Scholarship, and the Fred Wells Scholarship.
Maya LeClaire is receiving the Sunderland Women's Club Francis M. Clark Fine Arts Award.
Mary Lawrence is receiving the Greenfield Tennis Association Scholarship and the Yankee Candle Scholarship.
Joshua Levine is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
James LeClerc is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Bailey Lenarzik is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Madeline Leone is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Marshall Ehrenstam Memorial Scholarship, the Leonard T. Gribko Senior Scholarship, and the South Deerfield Women's Club Scholarship.
Genesis Locke is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Kevin Liu is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Madeline Lustenberger is receiving the Jeffrey C. Bednarski Memorial Award.
Ethan Michon is receiving the Conway Festival of the Hills Scholarship.
Benjamin Martino is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship and the Attorney George P. Gromacki Class of 1950 Memorial Award.
Peter Newman is receiving the Conway Festival of the Hills Scholarship and the Fred Wells Scholarship.
Mackenzie Peon is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Jeffrey C. Bednarski Memorial Award, and the Sunderland Women's Club Kimberly Zuski Community Service Award.
Devin Prusak is receiving the Conway Festival of the Hills Scholarship.
Hannah Ravish is receiving the Deerfield Police Relief Association Award.
Sean Richter is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Macy Ring is receiving the Class of 1969 Scholarship in honor of Michael Ferreter and the Sunderland Volunteer Firemen's Association Award.
Abigail Roberts is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Albert Hearing Scholarship, the Vi Goodnow Memorial Award, the David L. Scott Memorial Scholarship, and the Whately Grange Scholarship.
Aiden Roach is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the South Deerfield Women's Club Scholarship.
Olivia Rosewarn is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Mary A. Valadin Memorial Scholarship, and the Yankee Candle Scholarship.
Sophia Rossi is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship and the John T. Friggard Memorial Award.
Ethan Russell is receiving the Class of 1969 Scholarship in honor of Michael Ferreter.
Oliver Zachary is receiving the Sergeant Gregory Belanger Memorial Scholarship, the Class of 1969 Scholarship in honor of Michael Ferreter, and the Sunderland Men's Club George Pomeroy Award.
Megan Self is receiving the Mary Ryan Memorial Scholarship, the Union 38 Teachers Association Scholarship, and the Yankee Candle Scholarship.
Olivia Simoneau is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Amelia Sobieski is receiving the Hale Clap Post 3295 VFW Scholarship.
Sophia Stilla is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, the Stephen M. and Martha H. Barrett Scholarship.
Sierra Warren is receiving the Recorder Scholarship, the Whately PTO Award, and the Yankee Candle Scholarship.
Claire Winston is receiving the Caleb Charles Kinney Memorial Scholarship and the Yankee Candle Scholarship.
Kaylee Wisman is receiving the FRS Teachers Association Edna Beatty Award.
Heaven Woods is receiving the Greg Bielski Memorial Award and the Sergeant Gregory Belanger Memorial Scholarship.
Long Yao Chu is receiving the John and Abigail Adams Scholarship.
Benjamin Zoli is receiving the Deerfield Recreation Committee Award. On behalf of Frontier Regional School and the Class of 2021, I would like to thank the Frontier community for your generous support of our students. 60 community groups, scholarship committees, and organizations gave 125 awards to 60 of our seniors, totaling more than $51,000.
Scholarships and Senior Night Awards may be picked up after our commencement ceremonies at a table near the exit.
Next up is a slideshow put together by Abby and Ben Roberts.
I've been reading books of old, the legends and the myths, Achilles and his gold, Achilles and his gifts, and Spider-Man's control, and Batman with his fist, And clearly I don't see myself upon that list. But she said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, some fairy tale bliss. Just something I can turn to, somebody I can kiss. I want something just like this. Do 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 do. Oh, I want something just like this. Do do do.
So in closing, thank you for joining us this evening. Thank you to FCAT and to Kevin Murphy for help with the broadcast. Congratulations to all of our recipients. We will see everyone at graduation.
Good night.